Ahead of the verdict on the August 9th election results, the justices in the Supreme Court made statements to the press. Raila Odinga's legal team, who alleged the vote tallying process was fraudulently run, had contested the result. Deputy President William Ruto, 55, scraped victory by a margin of less than 2 percentage points in a tightly fought race against Odinga, a veteran opposition politician now backed by the ruling party. Odinga filed a petition to Kenya's top court last month, claiming he had enough evidence to show he had in fact won the election, which ranked as one of Africa's most expensive polls. Both the Ruto and Odinga camps had pledged to accept the court's ruling.
It is very important, even as we begin the journey as a nation, that we agree that Kenya is going to be a country based on the rule of law. Equally, we will respect the decision of the judiciary because we are a country based on the rule of law and respect for all the institutions. That is the only way we will remain democratic. That's the only way we will remain a constitutional country, and that is the only way the citizens of the Republic of Kenya will be equal.
Although voting day passed off peacefully, the results sparked angry protests in Odinga strongholds, and there are fears that the dispute could fuel violence in a country with a history of post-poll unrest. Judges spent the last 2 weeks sifting through boxes of evidence to establish if any irregularities were substantially enough to nullify the election, as was the case with the August 2017 presidential poll, which Odinga also challenged. Ruto, the 55-year-old incumbent deputy president, is now due to take office on September 13th.